Whether you need to lose weight or just stop gaining weight, people are now turning to weight loss medications more than ever to drop a few pounds. Weight loss medications are not new, but none have been quite as effective as the trendy new Ozempic. It's the Hollywood weight loss drug of stars and celebrities. Without insurance coverage, the price tag of $1,300 per month is way too steep for us normal people. Wegovy and Monjauro have the same sticker shock. So people have been turning to med spas, plastic surgeons, and even their primary care willing to provide semaglutide, the active ingredient in Ozempic, for a fraction of the cost. So what is semaglutide actually? What happens when you start taking it? And when does semaglutide actually start working? So day zero, you get to your healthcare provider and you ask for semaglutide because you're interested in dropping a few pounds. Because this agent is made by compounding pharmacies, you can't just go to Walgreens or CVS to pick it up. The clinic you go to might have some in their refrigerator, or they will order it from a compounding pharmacy. You might have to wait a few days to get started on your new medication. Semaglutide and Ozempic are what we call GLP-1 agonists. They stimulate the effects of a hormone called glucagon-like peptide 1 in your body. Now on day number one, you finally get your semaglutide. This medication is injected subcutaneously right into the fat layer under your skin. You can inject it in your abdomen, arm, leg, or anywhere you can pinch your skin away from your muscle. On the first day and starting at the lowest dose, you likely won't feel any different. Resist the temptation to inject a higher dose to get things moving along faster. The side effects are not worth it. By the second and third day, you might start to feel slightly less hungry at mealtime. Instead of eating a big plate of food or going back for seconds, you may find yourself satisfied with less. This is the whole point of semaglutide. GLP-1 agonists like Wegovy, Monjauro, Ozempic, and semaglutide all tell your brain that you are full. In addition, they decrease the rate at which your stomach empties food. These medications increase your production of insulin, and over time they decrease the amount of fat in your liver. These medications positively affect almost every major organ in your body. By now, semaglutide is definitely working if you are at the right dose. Your appetite is down, you're feeling more full after a smaller amount of food, and depending on what you've been eating, you may be losing a small amount of weight already. Day 8 is time for your second shot. Most healthcare providers will have you at the same dose of semaglutide for 4 shots, which is 4 whole weeks, to lessen your side effects. If you haven't had any side effects yet, you are lucky. The more common side effects of semaglutide are fatigue, headaches, nausea, and either constipation or diarrhea, especially if you are eating fatty foods. Appetite suppression continues the second week. If you are having GI issues, make sure to stay hydrated, do not eat a bunch of fatty foods, and stock up on those fruits and vegetables. Now it's time for your next shot. By now, semaglutide is reaching a steady state in your body. If you are not experiencing appetite suppression and feelings of fullness, you will likely need a larger dose. If the medication seems to be working, stay on your current dose. Semaglutide and Ozempic do not burn off weight just by taking it. You actually have to eat less calories or exercise enough to burn off more calories in order to lose the weight. These medications just make it easier to have better habits. You might not care about donuts and pizza as much as you did before. That's a good thing. Now you've hit your stride with this dose. Hopefully you have lost anywhere from 2 to 10 pounds. The more weight you have to lose, the faster it usually comes off. Spend the third week deciding whether or not you need to increase your dose after the first month or if you can stay here. Optimize your eating habits. Make sure you are eating enough protein to maintain your muscle mass during this weight loss period. By this last week, weight loss is in full swing. Keep eating your protein, keep drinking water. The tiredness you often felt the first few weeks should be going away, and your GI system should be more normal. You've now made it through the first month. Many people are down anywhere from 5 to 20 pounds by now. If you found this video useful, hit that thumbs up button and watch the video on this next screen.